ونتوكل عليه. إنه من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، we thank Almighty Allah again for giving us the opportunity to listen to the tafsir of Surah Al-Ahzab, the Surah of Al-Ahzab, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is educating Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how to deal with the kuffar, how to deal with the munafiqeen. Before we go into the detail of the ayat, what is the meaning of ahzab? Ahzab is a plural, and the singular for the ahzab is hizb. It means that we have the hizb is party. We can say ahzab groups or parties, different parties. And one is one hizb. Something very important that we need to know about how the name was given to the surah. First thing is that this surah, it has only one name, which is the Ahzab. Why the Ahzab? Why giving it that name? The name was given that surah because in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be addressing different cases of the kuffar and munafiqeen that gather together in order to persecute Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. In fact, it was mentioned that during the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being in Mecca, being in Medina, it was said that different groups from the kuffar, they gather together in order for them to harm the Prophet and his companion. Among them was one of these kuffar called I forgot his name. There are many Arab groups, Arab parties, and the Jews. They are all looking for ways to conquer Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to stop Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from all his preaches. And they went to him, giving Prophet Muhammad some excuses. They sent their delegates, their representatives. This one from Bani Qurayza, go. This one from Bani Fulan. They all sent their representatives. And they went to Prophet Muhammad sallam, and they started giving the Prophet sallam excuses why they were worshiping their idols that they were worshiping. As I said before, they were requesting from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give them all the support and that they are ready to provide for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam whatever he needed from them by then. When they continued to talk to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was said that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he just called on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, da'ani akuluhum jamiha. Let me just kill all of them. And Prophet said, no. You can't kill them. Because I've given them the assurance that they will be protected when they come to me, when they visit me. And after the discussions went on, and at the end, Prophet Muhammad said, Ya Umar, akhrujuhum, Just send them out. That's all. You don't need to kill them. Just send them out. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said, "Ukhruju fi lanati Allahi wa ghadabi." All of you, you this kuffar, get out of this place. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse you. And in Surah, that is why in the Ghazwat called Ghazwat Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to be with us and the peace of Iman. There are many verses in Surah Ahzab that has different sabab of nuzul. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayat? For example, the one we just mentioned about the story of the kuffar that went to Prophet Muhammad and they said, "Oh, Messenger of Allah, we don't need, even if you agree with us, you don't need to kill all these masakin that were around the Prophet Muhammad. But then, we're going to give you all the support that you need. Just allow us, permit us to continue worshiping our idol." It was said because of that case, that scenario, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah that says, "Min al-mu'minin rijalun sadaqu ma ahadu Allah alayhi, fa minhum man qada nahba, wa minhum man yantazir, wa man baddalu tabdila." Because the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they all gave all support that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam needed to him. May Allah increase us in that. Let's go straight to the ayat of Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ya ayyuha an-nabi, ya ayyuha an-nabi yuttaqillah ولا تطع الكافرين والمنافقين إن الله كان عليما حكيما واتبع ما يوحى إليك من ربك إن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا." Allah سبحانه وتعالى is addressing, amazing, that Allah is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to fear Allah, "Ya Rabb, ya ayyuha an-nabi yuttaqillah." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ittaqillah, fear Allah. وَلَا تُطْعِ الْكَافِرِينَ, and do not follow the steps of the kafirin, those that disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those that are against your teachings, those that came to you, appealing to you to allow them to continue to worship what they've been worshiping, those that came to you, asking you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to choose whatever he wants, to choose which one he wanted out of all the worldly material things. Say that if you want to be the richest among us, don't worry, we make it the richest. If you want to be high, you have to be have the highest title, it will be given to you. If it is because you want to marry a lot of women, don't worry, we'll provide them for you. Allah says, "La tuti'il kafirin." Those kafirun that are coming openly, requesting from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to follow their path, to allow them to continue to do what they are doing, never, don't ever follow them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, "Ittaqillah." Let's ponder upon this. Ittaqillah, for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one that Allah sent with the message, it says, as a mercy to this world, for Allah to be telling him, Itaqillah. And today, some believers, some people in this world, maybe because they are doing something, maybe because they've been in a position of leadership for a while, or maybe because they've been practicing Islam for decades, if you ask them to fear Allah, they will look at you and say, man, why are you to tell me to fear Allah? And as Muslims, this is a lesson for us that we should not fear anybody. We should not have fear for anybody. We just have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say the truth the way it is. If you have to remind Imam to fear Allah, you just have to be honest with what you are saying. You have to be honest in what you are saying. In a polite way, ittaqillah ya Imam. Fear Allah, Imam. If you have to tell the president, whoever that is in a position that is looking at himself or herself, that A, he is in a high rank position, don't fear him. Just fear Allah and be honest with what you're saying when you are reminding people to fear Allah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to fear Allah, who is he or she that we cannot tell to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Despite that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been praising Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Quran. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. Allah says, your character, your noble character, top all the noble characters of the world. Ala khuluqin azim. Subhanallah. Despite that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, inna fatahna laka fathan mubina liyakfi'a laka Allahu ma taqaddama min zambik وما تأخر ويتم نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما. Say, O Messenger of Allah, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا. We've opened the law of ways for you. If that is clear. And Allah says, لِيَكْفِيَ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَرُ. In order for Allah to forgive all the sins that he committed before and the one that you are about to commit. Plus all this, despite all this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still addressed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, ittaqillah, is a message. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in iman. Allah says, ittaqillah, fear Allah. وَلَا تُطِعِ الْكَافِرِينَ. And never follow the kafirin, the disbelievers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-kafirun, those that are ungrateful to Allah. They do not have the feeling of all the bounties of Allah around them. They do not have the feeling of all the blessings of Allah that surround them, that they are benefiting. They do not realize that Allah deserved to be worshipped alone, without associating any partner with Allah. Allah says, La tutil kafirin. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that we as believers, we have to be very careful. And we too, we should not follow the steps of the kafirin. if they are doing anything that is against the teachings of Allah, even if they are our friends, even if they are our families, they are members of our families, even if they are our fathers, mothers, uncles, we should not follow them. Remember the lessons of Surah Luqman, in Surah Luqman, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ جَاهَدَكَ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَائِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Even our parents, sorry, if they are disbelievers in Allah and the teachings of Allah, we should not follow them. We should not honor them in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَصَاهِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. Honor that in this dunya, you have to be kind to them. You have to be nice to them. Give them whatever they need. But if they encourage you to disbelieve in Allah, don't follow them. La tuti'il kafirin. Don't ever follow the kuffar. Don't ever follow the steps of the kuffar. La tuti'il kafirin. Wal munafiqin. And the munafiqin, the hypocrites. La tusma minhu wa la tastashiru. Don't ever listen to them. Don't ever seek for their advice, because they will be advising you wrongly. They'll be hiding some things for you. They'll be dealing with you in two faces. That is why, as Muslims, we have to be very careful and stay away from being munafiq. From being munafiq. May Allah Ta'ala make it easy for us. For us to stay away from being a munafiq, those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the believers, not to follow them, not to follow their steps. We need to know the signs of the munafiqin. The descriptions of the munafiqin. Those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that Prophet Muhammad should not follow them. What is munafiqun? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Alamatul munafiqi thalatha. The signs of the munafiqin are three. Their signs are three. Number one, إِذَا حَدَثَ كَذِبًا. When he talks, he lies. وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفَ. When he promises, he failed the promise. He will never fulfill the promise. وَإِذَا طُمِنَ خَانَ. When you keep any trust with them, they betray the trust. And in another hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, their signs are four. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith, أَرْبَعٌ مَنْ كُنَّا فِيهِ كَانَ مُنَافِقًا. There are three, four signs. Whoever has any of the four signs, he or she is a munafiq or munafiqa. And whoever has any of these signs in him or her, كَانَ فِيهِ حَصْلَ مِنَ النِّفَاقِ أَتَّى يَدَعْهَا. It will be among the munafiqin until it will learn the lesson and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, إذا حدث كذبا ونطاط إلائز وإذا وعد أخلف ونبرمز it will not fulfill the promise. وإذا خاصم number three in this hadith وإذا خاصم فجرا when he or she fight with people he or she will be uncontrollable. It will become a fragile, a thug that is not ready to listen to anybody. And Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, وَإِذَا أَهَدَ غَرَقَ when he promises and he keeps any trust with him, he will betray it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from being a munafiq. And again about this munafiq, in order for us to be careful and to know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, ittaqullah, number one, wa la tuti'il kafirin, and do not follow the steps of the kafirun, even if they are your friends. If they are your families, you just have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا Allah is the most knowledgeable, Hakim, and the most wise. Allah knows why He said what He said. And because sometimes people will be naive and they do not know what they're supposed to do. That is why we have to know this munafiqin. Al-Ulama said that among the signs of the munafiqin is that ulub umarida, they are sick in their hearts. That is why they do, at times they don't know the difference between the wrong and right. Or they know the difference between the wrong and right. But because of what they need, what they are looking for in this world, they just like to be munafiq. They will come to you and say, Salaam alaikum, hey. You see that brother, don't listen to him. And we go to the same person, the second party, say, hey, don't listen to me too. Because they are sick in their heart. Allah says in the Quran, fi qulubihim marad, fazadahum Allahu marada. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ They are sick in their heart. And Allah increased them in sickness. And the punishment, the severe punishment of Allah is expecting them in the Qiyamah with all their lies. Among the signs of the munafiqin, تَوَلِّي الْكُفَارِ وَمُعَدَاتِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ You will see them always in support of the kuffar. They will prefer their ideas, their knowledge. Even in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they follow them. And that is why Prophet Muhammad has warned us from following the path of the kuffar and the munafiqin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَشِّرِ الْمُنَافِقِينَ أَنَّ لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا And give the munafiqin the glad tidings. Give them their news of the punishment of Allah, the severe punishment of Allah that is expecting them. Who are these people? الَّذِينَ يَتَّخِذُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ Those that are choosing the kuffar as their awliya, their best friends. They are earlier, those that they trust more than the Muslims. More than the Muslims. Muslims, we have to be very careful in choosing this one of the people as our earlier. Even if you're having them among the community, those that are munafiqun. And munafiqun, they are dhulu wa jahil. They are people of two faces. A face will tell you that they are mu'minin, they are believers, because once in a while, we are praying together. And their second face will be for the kuffar. Maybe they come to you once a week, and 3 days in a week they go to other people, where they will be disbelieving in Allah together. People like that, you can have them as friends. Hello, Mr. A, Mr. B. Hello, Mrs. A, Mrs. C. But do not have them as their awliya. Their awliya, they are the people that you can rely on if anything happens. The awliya, they are the people that you can seek for their advice. And they will not mislead you. Even if it is tough for you, you have to have the mu'mineen as awliya. Those that both of you will be praying together, working together on how to increase your iman. Not those that will be moving you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make it easy for us. The munafiqun that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not to follow their path. They are the people that يَرْفُدُونَ تَحَكُمْ إِلَى شَرِعِ اللَّهِ. If you ask them to follow the teachings of Allah in the Quran, they say, oh, Imam, those teachings of Allah are difficult. Oh, we cannot do that. Oh, let's follow the Sharia. No, Sharia, no. I prefer to go to the court. Yeah, because if I go to the court will give me my rights. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in Iman. Another science, among the signs of the munafiqin, as-sukhriya min al-mu'mineen. You see them making jest of the believers as the munafiqin during the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are making jest of the kuffar, of the believers. They were saying, don't choose them as your people. We'll be there for you, to save you, to protect you. And they are munafiqun. And they'll be laughing at them, at mu'mineen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُ كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءُ أَلَا إِنَّهُمْ هُمُ السُّفَهَاءُ وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. In Surah Al-Baqarah verse 13, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا. When they were told, when they were given the da'wah to believe in Allah, كَمَا آمِنَ النَّاسِ, as the believers have the belief in Allah, قَالُوا, the munafiqun, they will be saying, أَنُؤْمِنُ كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَاءُ. Do you want us to have iman the way these poor people, the sufa, the blind people, as they're having the iman? No. Here in America, we're here to make money. You're asking me to give you my money and then you multiply. No. If it is only $5 I can give you, I will give you. SubhanAllah. No, I can do that. I'm not done. Even someone would tell you, I'm not done. Oh, do you think that people that are giving it, they are dumb? Do you think that people that are paying in the path of Allah, that are struggling, working for their journey, do you think that they are dumb? I mentioned the story of a miskin that he and his family, they were going through a tough time during the time of Prophet Muhammad. And in their surroundings, in their area, there was a man with huge plantation, the huge farm of dates, and a branch of one of the date trees were falling on the wall. And this was again, whenever they are passing by, his children are passing by, they will be picking some of these dates. And one day, this man went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah, he said, Ya Rasulullah, this man of our neighborhood is having hundreds of trees in his farm. Oh, Messenger of Allah, can you please appeal to him to even allow us if you just have to be fetching one of the three, if you cannot give it to us completely. And Prophet Muhammad said, okay, go and call him for me. Because the man was among those that at times they would listen to Prophet, and at times they would run away. And Prophet Muhammad told him, he said, oh man, can you give your tree to this miskin and his family? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay you back in the day of Qiyamah with a tree of the Qiyamah that its branches will cover all, even all the areas that your eyes can reach. Look at the front where your eyes can reach, your left, your back. And man said, oh, oh, messenger of Allah, I'm not dumb. I'm not stupid. You want to take my tree in this world and promise me with another tree in Jannah? No, I don't want that. Astaghfirullah. And one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those that are having true iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he just rise up and he said, oh, messenger of Allah, a tree in this dunya with trees, one tree of the king of Jannah. Ya Rasulullah, I'm having a garden in this Medina that is full of dead trees. Even I'm having, he said he was having more than 600 trees. And I'm ready to give the whole farm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wow. In order for me to have a tree in Jannah. And this man went to his farm. And his wife and his children, they were there playing in the garden. Even one of the children was having a dead in his mouth. And the man was telling his family, let's get out of the farm. Let's get out of the farm. The farm has been sold to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a tree in the Jannah. And the righteous wife, she agreed with her husband immediately. Yalla, yalla, let's go, let's go. Our farm has been sold for a tree in Jannah. And Prophet Muhammad said, Rabbi had tijarat Abu Dahda. The trading of Abu Dahda with Allah was successful. Brothers and sisters, Islam, let's try to be honest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in iman. We mentioned that the munafiqun at times yudhirun al iman wa yubtilun al kufra. At times they will show you that yes, we are mu'mineen, yes, we are believer, and they will be hiding that kufr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why Allah says, Surah Al-Munafiqun, إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا نَشْهَدُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُهُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَافِرُونَ. When the munafiqun, when they come to you, they'll be telling you that, yeah, we believe in Allah. In fact, we believe that you're a messenger of Allah. And Allah says, they don't need to tell you that. Allah knows that you are his messenger. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُهُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَاذِبُونَ. And Allah is bearing witness that the munafiqun, they are all liars. Another thing we need to know about nifaq, about the munafiqeen, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam not to follow their approach. The ulama say that there are two grades of nifaq. There is a nifaq that is called nifaqul asdan, nifaq that is minor, like nifaq in dealings. One can repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his nifaq, when dealing with people through faces, I love you, and he's hiding something else. How do you mind that human being can even forgive me? Another one that is the worst one, as a nifaq al-i'tiqadi, nifaq that has to do with aqidah. If you are nifaq, if you have that nifaq, you have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That people that you will see that as mu'minin, as believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the next day you will see them doing something else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us iman. May Allah answer our prayers and reward us abundantly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the second ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, while addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. Allah says, oh Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, اتبع ما يوحى إليك من ربك. Follow all the teachings of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealing to you, that Allah is revealing unto you. من ربك إن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware. He has the knowledge of all what you are doing. You don't need to let people see it. You have to know that Allah sees everything. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one that when Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, when she was asked about the characters of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our mother Aisha radiallahu anha said, kana khuluqu al-Qur'an. His character is Quran. Go to the Quran, whatever the Quran says, that is the character of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that understood the Quran more than any one of us. Allah says, "Inna Allah kana bima ta'maluna khabira." Allah has the knowledge of all what you are doing. Allah is expert in that. Allah can see your intention of doing whatever you are doing. That is why you have to let people know that the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Innama al-a'mal bin-niyyat wa innama likulli imrin ma nawa." All our actions will be judged based on our intention. "Fa'innama likulli imrin ma nawa." And for every soul, the reward or the result of whatever he did in his life. We as human beings, let's leave everything into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If somebody says that he's worshiping Allah, pray to Allah to accept it from him. And another lesson that this will lead us to is for the ummah to try to work together. Enough is enough of separations among the ummah because of some minor issues. If we have an argument, if we are discussing it for the benefit of having the knowledge of knowing that what is our dream is also right, and what the bees are doing is also right. Either you do it this way or do it that way, both are right. That would be the best thing for us. Not for us to be arguing in order for us to cause divisions among the ummah, in order to generate hatred among the ummah. I've seen people that hate other people, other believers, just because of minor things. Just because they're raising their hands in dua, and you say, these are alu dalal, alu nair, alu whatever. Subhanallah. We don't need to do that. Maybe because some people are using sibha, for example. Some people will have it in mind as if have been in a garden. But somebody said that if you have aqidah of ta'wil, the aqidah of ta'wil is to have the belief that when Allah says, Yadullahi fawqa aydihim. See, Yadullahi fawqa aydihim or fawqa aydihim. Yadullahi fawqa aydihim. The hand of Allah is on top of their hand. It's on top of their hands. Some school of thought says that whenever it says hand, it has to be hand. Only that you don't need to look for how the hands of Allah look like. Okay, alhamdulillah, that's an understanding. Another school of thought says that, whenever it says Yadullah, it means Quwwatullah, the power of Allah, or Iradatullah, or the support of Allah. That's an understanding. We don't have to call those that are saying that the Yad of Allah is the Quwwa of Allah, is the power of Allah, is the Qudra of Allah. We don't need to call them Kuffar because of that. We don't need to call them Mushrikun because of that. Even if some are calling them Mushrikun, we that we understood of the teachings of Allah that says, Fattaqullah amastata'atum. Fear Allah with all your ability. Fear Allah as much as you can. Okay. Leave them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if we argue from today till another century, you will still have some people that are having their own belief in this way, and others will be having their own belief in that way. When Allah says, Wattabi ma yuha ilayka min rabbik, inna Allah kana bima ta'maluna khabira. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in iman. We pray to Allah to answer all our prayers. As we are about to finish Ramadan, inshallah, possibly today or tomorrow will be the end of the Ramadan for year 1441, Hijri, year 2020 and Miladi. We as believers, we have to know that we've built a huge house that is full of taqwa and iman. And that house, we should not destroy it with our own hand. We should not destroy it with our deeds by moving back to all the forbidden things, like illegal sexual intercourse, drinking alcohol, consuming the wealth of others in haram. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran 47, verse 23, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, all you who believe, atti'ullah, follow the teachings of Allah, wa atti'ur rasul, and follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa la tubtilu a'malakum, and do not destroy your deeds. Do not destroy your iman. Do not destroy the taqwa that you've attained. That is why, well, after the month of fasting, the month of Ramadan, we have to keep our mouth fasting from backbiting, from abusing people, from insulting people, from consuming anything that we know that it is haram. We have to let our soul and our heart in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. As we are remembering Allah during the month of Ramadan, Let's continue to do the same thing after the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Let's remember to do all the right thing, to continue to be nice and good to people, to the masakeen, especially by giving our zakat al-fitr, which we're supposed to pay before the end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each and every one of us. Again, after the month of Ramadan, after the end, let's start fasting the 6 days of Shawwal. The Prophet Muhammad said, whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and follow it with 6 days of Shawwal, it will be as if he fasts the whole year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. May Allah increase us iman. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم استغفر الله وغفور رحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
تكبر الله الحمد لله رب العالمين. We thank our imam for that beautiful presentation of Tafsir from Surah Al-Ahzab. We pray to Almighty Allah to continue to reward you abundantly. We pray to Him to accept all the effort as ibadah. We really appreciate the short notice, and for the fact that you were somewhere before you came on board for the Yoruba Tafsir, and almost back to back, we had the English Tafsir as well. We pray to Almighty Allah to count all this strife, all this effort, to make all of them heavy on your scale of good deeds. Amen. So, we don't have questions. We expected to have gotten some questions, but we don't have. But I have one or two questions here. I don't know whether I can just go ahead to ask Imam some of the questions that we have. So, Imam, the question that I have from my end is, if somebody has gotten to know that he or she has some traits of a munafiq, and he is now reflecting over the tafsir that you have just given, so how can he go about the process of tawbah? If he wants to do tawbah, how is he or she going to go about it, inshallah?
The best way for the processing of tawbah is for the person to have it in mind that is ready to repent for what he or she is doing. He or she can perform 2 rakah of nafila. And after the nafila, he will just seek for forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and promise Allah that he will never go back to it. The ulama, they said that the steps of tawbah are 3. The first is anadam ala mafat, to regret of all what has been done, to regret it. Wow, why should I do that? To regret it. And number 3, raddul madhalim, to return whatever he cheated with. If it has to do with nifaq, in consuming other people's right wrongly, he or she has to return that thing. And now if he cannot return it, he can just approach the person that he cheated before and request for forgiveness from them. And the third of it is to promise Allah that he or she will never return back to it again. May Allah make it easy for us. I think these are the steps of the tawbah processes.
Jazakallah khairan. So, there will be a clarification to the response, the later part of the response. So if somebody has now cheated somebody, and that person is no more, if that person has died, And I'm still feeling remorse for that. I wish I could have gone to that person and, you know, let him know that I have wronged him or her. But the person is no more now. So is there any other way the person can rectify his or her mistake?
Allahu alam. I remember that I read something about that. You can just repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. And in the day of Qiyamah, if the person repents to Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his repentance. Because the tawbah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is open. But we have to be very careful in cheating one another. Because in the day of Qiyamah, that dhulmu, that cheating can block the person from entering into the Jannah. To answer the question again, you just need to repent to Allah and keep on making istighfar. With that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him. Remember the story of the man that killed 99 people. By killing innocent people, I think he wronged those people. Am I right? He wronged them by killing them.
No.
If you remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةِ كُلِي وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةِ قُتِلَتْ Abi? وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةِ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّذَا بِنْ قُتِلَ الْمَوْءُودَ They are the unborn babies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that you will be asked why the baby was killed. I think the best thing is for the person not to say that the man already died, I don't need to seek for forgiveness if Allah wants. No, he has to continue to seek for forgiveness of Allah. If Allah can forgive the one that killed 99 people, that added another person to make it 100, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him or her too. May Allah make it easy for us. Do I answer the question?
Yes, you did, Imam. Jazakallah khairan. Now, somebody is also asking a question here, and I want all other participants to really pay attention, because when people are asking questions, they want to learn. And no matter how ridiculous or how fun the question might sound, we shouldn't make jest of people asking the questions. People really want to learn, and that's why they are asking. So the person asking questions says, can a woman with a lot more Quran knowledge lead the family in prayer if the husband only knows very few surah, like Surah Al-Ikhlas and Surah Al-Kawthar, and the woman has more, the wife, so to speak, knows a lot? Can she lead the family, including her husband, in Salat?
No. In Islam, a woman cannot lead Salat, cannot lead even just one man in Salat. She cannot lead her own son that have reached the age of puberty, or that can differentiate between the right and wrong. That is it. Among the conditions of the imam, the shurutul imama, is for the imam to be a man. She can lead groups of women with maybe her babies that are still underage. She can lead them. But so far they're having a boy, or the husband is there, even if the husband knows only Fatiha and Kulu Allah or Inna Atena, the husband will remain the imam of the house. And she will be benefiting her children with her knowledge. May Allah make it easy and increase us. No.
Ameen. Jazakallah khairan. So another question here says, especially it has to do with our political leaders.
Okay.
When when they are seeking offices, they will come with their manifestos. They will do this. They will do that. They will do this. They will do that. And they will get the votes and they get to power. So now when they get to power, we see that some of the signs of munafik that you highlighted, they are just exhibiting all those signs. Because in terms of the promise they have given, they are breaking it. And in terms of the trust, that people put the trust of the state under them, they mess up that trust. And even the money that belongs to the whole people, they squander and spend the money. So looking at all this, is it appropriate for us to tag and call our leaders, political leaders who have failed in their promises, to call them munafiq or munafiqun?
We can call them, we can give them another name. We can call them Zalimun. If we call them Zalimun, they are cheaters, they are looters. I think it can cover the munafiqun too. They can be munafiq by doing that. Because they will come to us and say, yeah, we're giving you everything. We've already donated 10 billion whatever to your city. And they were lying. Are you with me? And they were lying in what they are saying. When you are saying that you gave people money and you didn't give it to them, already you have one of the traces of being a munafiq. That Prophet Muhammad said, Alaymatu munafiq thalatha. The signs of the munafiq are three. Wa idha hadatha kathiba. When he talks, he lies. If there are politicians, if they are lying, it means that they are munafiqun. If they are consuming other people's right wealth wrongly, it means that they are munafiqun. Let me quickly give you the. Let me go back to the question that you asked. Are you with me? Regarding the one that cheated that had already died. Are you with me? They asked one of us about it. And he said, Sebuguan Gomi.
Agoye, now.
Okay. They said, Falwajib alayka tawba al mustaqbil al arkaniya. The person just needs to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to promise that Allah that it will not return back to that type of act again. Waradul mazalim in kanat unaka mazlama. If he really cheated people, he or she has to return what he cheated with. And they say that if what he cheated with is money or something that is valuable, فالواجب, it is compulsory on that person again. رد هذه المظلمة إلى الورثة إن علموا. He or she has to return what he cheated with to the ورثة, to the family of that person, if they were told about it. Waila, even if they were not told about it and they have knowledge about it, and the issue is between him and that person, they said, فتصدق بها بنية وصول الثواب إلى صاحبها. He has to give that money in charity. He has to give it out to other masakin as a sadaqah, with the intention that the reward of that sadaqah will go to the person that he cheated. وَإِنْ كَانَتْ الْمَظْلَمَ غَيْرُ مَالِيَّةٍ. If what he cheated with has nothing to do with money, فَعَلَيْكَ أَنْ تُكْثِرَ مِنَ الْعَمَالِ الصَّالِحَةِ حَتَّى تُقَدِّمُ أَلْقَ تُقَدِّمَ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَعِنْدَكَ مِنَ الْحَسَنَاتِ مَا قَدْ يُقَابِلْ تِلْكَ الْمَظْلَمَةِ. It says that the man or the person has to be doing a lot of hasanat, good deeds, that will cover what he cheated with in the day of Qiyamah. Because by the time his good deeds will be used to pay back the person that he cheated, what will remain for him or her will be enough to earn him or her the Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Another advice that he or she has to be full of dua. For the person that he cheated, wal istighfaru lahu la'allahu yafu an. And he or she will be making istighfar for the person that he cheated. Possibly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use that istighfar to cover for what he cheated with. I think the best advice is for us to always try to stay away from cheating one another, because according to the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever one cheated with in this world, he will bring it back in the day of Qiyamah to pay that person back with it, which means that all his good deeds will be used to pay them back. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in iman and increase us in taqwa. Answer our prayers and reward us upon it. Now.
Jazakallah khairan. I think that's about it for today, because looking at the time now, it's around 7:15, and we do have the little presentation to prepare our community for Eid. Like we said before, we don't have any information as of now that the moon has been sighted anywhere, so which means that means we might still have to fast tomorrow.
Yes.
So if you get any information after Salat al-Maghrib, it will let us know. But as we speak now, we have not gotten any confirmed information of moon being sighted anywhere. So at this point, I want to say Jazakallah khairan to our Imam for giving us a beautiful tafsir this evening, both the Yoruba and the English versions. We pray to Almighty Allah to accept the effort as ibadah, as we also pray to Him to give us the better understanding of what you have shared with us, and give us the opportunity and the ability to put everything into practice. Jazakallah khairan. May Allah reward you abundantly. Ameen. So, inshallah, I have a little presentation.